My life be like, ooh, yeah, ooh. My life be like,
and it was kind of cold out, so we had a fire, and all of South just sat by the fire.
Was when I used to push people into bushes during my freshman and sophomore year.
It was during Petty Week, especially when all the boys got to sleep over in the dining hall all by ourselves. That was pretty fun.
Sadie this year, because we all got ready in Annie. We spent all day getting ready, which was probably pretty unnecessary.
We had an all-out water fight. It was like World War III with water on the third and second floor of Lakeside.
Petty Week, when it was senior pranks, and it was the night that we were allowed to like go around and do the pranks and stay out late. And I remember we, like a bunch of the senior girls and a few senior guys, just we walked around campus like blasting music in the girls' soccer speaker, and we decorated Clinton.
Later that afternoon, we had another water fight.
All the times that Hallie and Lula and I would come up with these grand plans for like 3-course meals and go to Acme, get all the ingredients, and then go to the Mantegna's house late at night.
Definitely sitting in Morgan and Shane's room playing video games and watching Netflix.
Junior year, we had the guys versus girls wiffle ball tournament outside of Lakeside and Catherine. It was just like sunny, it was in the spring, and we were playing music.
During Petty Week senior year, when all of us were in our underwear, and ran around the entire campus, and we went into every single girl's dorm, and Mason, couldn't forget about Mason, and we all sang.
Every sophomore year, all the boys in West played manhunt during the snowstorm.
The grade wide manhunt, and we went out of bounds, and we got scolded.
Went around the dorm, knocking on people's doors and running away between the hours of like 12 and 4 a.m.
You know, my first crush was actually Aidan Smart.
My first crush at Blair was probably Alex Kirby or Kate Curtin.
My first crush was Garrett Lamont.
My first crush was Elizabeth Malfort.
I had a crush on Tim Launders after.
All right, my first Blair crush was Lula Mantegna.
And my first Blair crush was probably Thomas Engel.
Junior, I had such a crush on Thomas and he never noticed.
I'd probably say Michael O'Connell. Just a good kid in general.
My friend crush is probably Michael O'Connell.
Definitely Michael O'Connell.
Yeah. I made a complete fool of myself in front of him at convocation at the beginning of the year. But I think Michael O'Connell is ridiculously cool.
I always had a friend crush on like Sejal, but I was always too scared to do anything about it.
My friend crush is Sarah Richardson.
Probably Emilia Lula, Thomas Engel.
I have a big kind of crush on Mr. Antonelli because I feel like he hates me. But, like, I really want to be friends with him.
So my confession is for Miss Fanfast. There was a night where the boys were coming back from a wonderful dinner provided by Mr. Mazza.
Ellie, confession, I'm the one who takes all your Under Armour socks.
And two of the day students, me and my fellow day student Andrew, drove back, convoying a bunch of other boarders without riding permission back to Mason.
The lock prefect lost all of the bras from Petty Week, and we have not given back any of them.
And I guess some horns were honked and loud music was played. And Andrew was ripped a new one in kind of the common area of Mason on the second floor by Miss Standfast while I was laying down hiding on Aidan Smart and Aidan Stockhausen's couch.
Not being dressed good. Yeah, basically always. Okay, eighth grade, when I was living in Freeman, I walked through the dorm with my family and I turned a corner and bumped into some boy, I don't remember who, and he was wearing a towel, but like up here.
Going to the bathroom in the girls' bathroom actually be one of my Blair highlights, yeah, just because it's so nice in there.
Bryce, you have any confessions?
Nothing that won't put me in jail.
The best advice I ever received was just somebody told me, say yes. Blair has so many things to offer, whether it be socially, academically, in terms of extracurriculars, so many cool things to try. And if you just say yes to opportunities given to you, you'll find something that you love to do and you'll have a great time doing it.
My personal advice to you, the underclassmen, is to take more risks.
Be honest with each other, and every friendship can be mended. So even if you guys argue and fight, just make sure you respect and understand what the other person is trying to say and feel and communicate to you.
Definitely join sports here. Like, even if you're nervous about making a team or whatever you might be nervous of, just do it, because Blair Athletics has been the highlight of my 4 years here every year.
Advice I've ever received would be, you know, embrace the moment. You know, studying is important, of course, and, you know, it's really hard to get off your phone. But when it's time to go, really care about your friends and the moments that you guys made together.
Balance out your academic and your social life, because, like, you can really get caught up in one or the other. So I'd say not one is more important than the other.
One, don't be afraid to push yourself and trying to meet new people and do new things, because you never know who you're going to become friends with.
But just enjoy that time with your friends, because it goes by quick.
SMB, don't wait, because a lot of the things I did senior year, I said to myself, it's your senior year, you have nothing to lose. And I ended up having a really great time. And I think that if I had said that kind of stuff to myself freshman, sophomore, junior year, I would have had a lot more fun. And just don't wait for the right opportunity. Your heart, it looks just like mine, where there's no use in wasting your time anymore. I'm sorry I haven't been myself. Something's got me down. What it is I can't.